It is 1969 and the borders are finally not that bad for once. But I think that's mostly down to the fact that, well, yeah, the Ukrainians didn't really get involved like the Soviets usually do, as I thought they would, so they just kind of stayed out of it, and now World War II is basically just a stalemate. Yeah, I finally figured out the time-lapse overhaul mod exists, and that's how you got the flags to represent the divisions, but it made the game run so slow. Like, I swear there was a mod in the workshop that allows you to shackle the AI, you know, that way if they're a neutral nation, they're not really, you know, spamming out divisions. Because Paraguay is not even doing anything. Why do they need 26 divisions? Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's a mod to combat this type of shit. I just need to find it. Hopefully that might help performance, so that way we can actually get a bit further to the fall of the Axis or something, while still having the flags. Because I know you like seeing the divisions just migrating across the board, you know, just fighting and the action. It's a little bit of an extra boost for engagement, and I like that. Hopefully the time-lapse overhaul mod was worth it and I actually get some sort of engagement, but I guess we'll see. Hey, they actually got the name right this time. It's actually called Australian Malaya, instead of just being called British Malaya, when in reality it's an Australian puppet. But yeah, good job, you actually got the name right this time. Also, you might have noticed that I consolidated some nations, like, you know, uniting Central America under El Salvador, but that's mostly because El Salvador is about the only one in Central America who does anything, and I was trying to, you know, delete some unnecessary nations that don't really do anything to help with the performance. That clearly didn't happen, as, again, the AI just loves to spam out divisions. Like, look at all this! But yep, the main focus of the video, Ukraine. I guess they didn't really do much, sadly. I guess they didn't really get involved, they're just kind of neutral. Yep, they just kind of stayed here, and have these got their freedom? No, they're probably, yeah, they're dominions now. I swear, the AI loves to do this every time! Also, something interesting, we have Hungarian Poland. They also have the Slovakian puppet, which I swear it's usually Germany that gets this, but I guess they just gave it over to Hungary, which I guess makes sense considering Germany has all of France. Why would they care about Slovakia? Also, Italy has completely failed on the African front. That's pretty typical. Even Germany owns this bit of Nigeria, the god territory. No, apparently Italy lost all of East Africa and Libya. Classic Benito, am I right? But then again, Benito and the Axis kind of made this mess down the Balkans. Great job just releasing Albania and Montenegro. Was that really that necessary? Also, Japan is still quite the heavyweight, still conquering the Pacific. And as for China, I see they've gone with the EU4 strategy of vassal feeding. Although China is for some reason democratic now. Yep, fascism is plummeting in popularity and Wang Wenhao is here. Okay then, don't know how Japan allowed that. Remember, we have a 1.5k sub goal where I'm going to be doing a time lapse on the Islamic State Millennium Dawn. Although by the looks of it, it's probably not going to come here earlier for the sub goal. I swear, if everyone watching right now that wasn't subbed hit the sub button, I would not only be well above the sub goal, but also probably monetized. Maybe even close to 10k, but no, for some reason, like 90% of you aren't subbed. I don't know why. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Danny!